It feels baller.
Hey, you feel rich when you have one.
What are your superpowers again?
I'm rich.
Welcome to a video format that we have not done in a very long time. I'm sure like you guys, we were home during quarantine watching GQ.com's YouTube channel, and we were watching the 10 things that we cannot live without. I watched a bunch of them, whether that was Lil Baby.
Never wear the same underwear, t-shirts, and tank top. I change my t-shirt, my tank top, and my underwear every day.
Kevin Love, and I figured, hey, we got things we can't live without too. 10 things that we cannot live without.
On the Fung Bros channel. Not GQ. The number one thing that we cannot live without, starting off the list, is our U-Scooter GT 2020.
You guys, the future's here now. We're on hoverboards.
Future!
I think it's the best one in terms of usability, motor power, ability to take in and out of restaurants and stores. That's actually low-key pretty important.
Scooting around the city and getting to places quickly and running errands in it, no-brainer, this is the best thing we have. It has changed the way we move.
For anybody, obviously within the city core, that's a no-brainer. Once you get 5 to 10 miles out, like an industrialized suburb, I still think it's useful.
And I'm telling you guys, it's the wintertime already and we've put these things through a lot. So we've been beating up our new scooters and they have survived. They're extremely durable. Guys, this is not a sponsored post, but if you would be interested in getting a U-Scooter GT 2020, you can use our code down below, PhoneBros, for $60 off. But in general, I'm just telling you to look into electric scooters in general.
Dude, I mean, some of them are $500. They do range up to like $3,000, $4,000. I would say most people probably buy one around $500, $1,000.
But would you say, David, it's safe to say you will get what you pay for?
For the most part, yes.
Electric scooters. This emoji.
It's the wave. Number two are bathroom organizing accessories.
I mean, I think these are no-brainers if you live in a small apartment and you have a small bathroom. But even if you have a big one, you gotta look into these. So some of the ones that we personally have are, number one, a motion sensing soap dispenser. It looks really cool, it's very convenient, and actually, with the batteries inside, it lasts a long time.
I think that, just in general, you don't wanna touch your hand soap dispenser. I always thought that was weird. You have to get your hands dirty to get your hands clean initially. It feels baller.
Hey,
you feel rich when you have one.
What are your superpowers again?
I'm rich.
We've been using ours for over 3 months and we have not replaced the batteries yet. The next one we're talking about is the toothbrush organizer and holder that just sticks onto the wall, because not all walls can be drilled into, okay? And this one really comes off clean. It can hold a lot.
I actually think all bathroom adhesive accessories in 2020 have really gotten a lot stronger. Back in the day, when you wanted to upgrade your bathroom, there was a lot of drilling, there was a lot of, you need to get a handyman or like you might mess up something.
I mean, I think that adhesive accessories, it's at a whole new level, guys. It's totally passable and it will organize your bathroom.
It is true that as you get older too, you accumulate more bathroom things. Yeah. Like when I was younger, I didn't have a tongue scraper. I own my own tongue scraper now.
Trust me, I got more than one moisturizer, okay? And more than one face wash, all right? Unfortunately, I need them. The next one, guys, David, this one's a funny one. It's the bathroom sound machine.
If anybody's ever had like the living room bathroom that everybody uses, I mean, I don't wanna get into the details, but like,
it's out of courtesy. The next one is the silicone toilet brush. This is pretty self-explanatory. It's a lot more hygienic and cleaner than the, you know, traditional brush toilet bowl cleaner.
The bristles.
These are all just things to make your bathroom more pleasant, because I'm not gonna lie, our bathroom gets used a lot. All right, next one, the bathroom door organizer for $11, super easy. I think traditionally a lot of people put like shoes in them, but you can use them for bathroom items, just hang it on the back of your wall. It's even an adhesive.
And I think that surprisingly, they look clean and they don't look super ugly. But I think for people who want to stay organized, but they just wanna be quick with it, the on-the-door organizers are a 10 out of 10.
All right, the last one is the motion sensing lights. These are good for when, you know, you wake up in the middle of the night or early in the morning and don't want to turn on the actual light to the bathroom because it's too bright. You just walk in and these motion sensing lights will give you just enough light to do what you need. Yo, I'm telling you, when you wake up in the middle of the night and you need to, you know, do your thing and then you walk into the bathroom and you turn on the lights, you're just shocked by everything.
You don't want-
Very unpleasant.
No, you don't want 5,600 Kelvins in your eyeball.
Bro, just get the motion sensing lights. All right, so all these bathroom items pretty much add up to a little bit over $100, but that's a small price to pay considering how organized your bathroom actually will be. All right, so the third thing that we cannot live without, and especially being people who do a lot of exercise, are the massage guns. And going along with how kind of like electric scooter tech is advancing, this is advancing quickly too.
For example, the Cinca is only like $130, and this is great because it gives you something soft, but if you really wanna get deep too into the muscle tissue, you have something a little bit more heavy duty like a Theragun.
Bro, this is for when you get home and you're super sore, use this, the Theragun. But guys, massage guns, they range anywhere from like, I've seen them for $70 up to $400, so you get to choose. All right, so number four on our list, the thing that we can't live without, it's a keychain accessory, but it is the super bright LED keychain that's rechargeable. And it's super key that it's rechargeable by micro USB.
I think that a lot of times people really underestimate how useful just light is for when you wanna fix something for your own security.
And I love it how these come in different forms. I mean, this one's a little bit bigger and it's a little bit brighter, 650 lumens. And then this one's at 600 lumens. Any keychain light, just think about getting one.
Number five, I cannot live without the Sonos Move. So this is probably one of the more expensive Bluetooth speakers you can get, but I think it actually rivals home speakers in terms of quality.
When we put it in the corner of the apartment, it has a really full sound. The bass is pretty good. I mean, when it comes to Bluetooth speakers, a lot of them are pretty good and they'll get the job done, but it really comes down to battery life, looks, and quality of sound.
I would say that this is one of the first Bluetooth speakers that's ultra portable, it's water resistant, it's dust resistant, it's drop resistant. I would say that is in the high tier of quality. I've been giving Sonos Moves to people at like wedding gifts, and that's when you know that you really believe in something, when you're spending your own money to buy it for other people.
I will say one slight thing to remember though, is that if you like to hook up a lot of multiple speakers, probably the JBL system is easier to handle. All right, so number six, of course, everybody's gonna be wearing masks for a while, and these Under Armour premium face masks that are washable are the ones that we're using to play basketball in. They keep their shape. They are a little bit more expensive. They're $30 each, but they're washable.
You know, for the most part, a lot of people agree that these Under Armour face masks are probably your best option for feeling really safe while also doing some strenuous activity. I know people who do martial arts in these, who box in these, who play basketball in these. It's like five layers thick, but it still feels breathable.
I like even using these while I ride because there's no wind chill that gets through it. Also, it really keeps its shape while you're doing exercise, so you're not like, you don't end up like sucking in your own mask, which oftentimes happens if you're using like cheaper masks. It's definitely worth looking into, guys. $30, the Under Armour premium face masks.
Number seven, we got the Dyson V11. I'd almost have to say, Andrew, this is the U Scooters GT 2020 of vacuums.
Very efficient, it's super easy to clear out this cartridge here, and actually the battery lasts a really long time as long as you don't use it on the super boost level.
It is pricey.
It's pricey, it's almost $600, but if you are constantly vacuuming your apartment and you need a good vacuum, this is something you should think about.
Now, real quick, I do want to address something because somebody's gonna say, why are you recommending the Sonos? That's the probably the most expensive, you know, consumer Bluetooth speaker.
Okay.
And the V11 is one of the, maybe the most expensive vacuum you can get. Any item, to me, there's always an equation based off the usage rate. If you're gonna use an item like 10 times a day, it makes sense to buy an expensive version that's really highly rated. You're actually just distributing that cost per use.
Exactly. All right, guys, coming in at number eight, we have Fruit Water, and particularly by Sanzo. It is a New York-based company. These are a lot of Asian flavors. It's made with real juice. Every time we go to a restaurant, I like squeezing a little bit of lime or lemon into my water to begin with. So this is just kind of like that next iteration. And honestly, there is no better lychee water than this one.
Really progressive, sort of cutting-edge Asian-American restaurants are carrying them right now. But this is almost just like the Asian Spindrift.
The way that you're gonna have to buy it is you're gonna have to go on their website or go to certain retailers that are carrying it. All right, guys, coming in at number nine on our list is not AirPod Pros, but these little memory foam earplugs right here. My current AirPods were not even staying in my ear when I was doing push-ups or jumping jacks, but these I can actually exercise in. They're $13 off Amazon. I mean, there's no other AirPod that I can run in except for these. So it's an attachment. You take off your rubber one, you snap on this one. All right, coming in at number 10, we've been talking about a lot of items that require electricity and things that need electricity need to be charged. So what are you gonna charge them with? Well, you can get these multi-head charging cords. They come with lightning cord, USB-C, which, you know, so many items are moving towards. And then you have your micro USB, and sometimes you get another lightning cord right there.
Previously, maybe even like 5 years ago, they had these, but they weren't very good. iPhones or whatever would not even recognize them.
Devices not supported. That thing.
I think nowadays in 2020, man, these multi-prong heads, they got really good reviews. I haven't had any of them break on me.
Right. I would say if you get the more expensive one, they're probably gonna be higher quality. You can get the cheap one, but I mean, again, if this is something that you're using every day, it's okay to spend a few extra dollars and get the higher quality one.
All right, you guys, that does it for the 10 things that we cannot live without right now. You know, there was no Louis bag in there. I think that these are all gadgets that can benefit your life. Like, I can't imagine under that many circumstances, to be honest, Andrew, that the regular toilet brush is better than the silicone rubber one.
Obviously, things like the electric scooter are literally gonna change your life, and that's why we put that number one. But everything else is really important, guys. These are the things that we found out we use every day, we look at every day, you see every day.
I really think that in 2020, you can use electric tech to change your life. It's finally here, guys. I don't necessarily work in that field. I'm just more on the consumer end. But let me just tell you, as a consumer, the revolution is here. All right, Andrew, if you had to pick one thing out of everything, and you can't pick the used scooters. I think the Sonos Move to me is something where I'm like, wow, Bluetooth tech in 2020 finally turned that corner.
My thing that I gotta pick is definitely the massage guns, because guys, previously I would have to get that little roller and I have to roll my calf and I stick my calf up and stick my leg up, and it's just like a lot more trouble and it's not as effective. So shout out to Percussive Therapy. I'm such a fan. That's why we have two of them.
All right, you guys, thank you so much for watching that video. These are 10 things that we cannot live without. Maybe the list could change in the future as new things come in and go out. Maybe you guys can let us know what 10 things you guys cannot live without in the comment section below. And until next time, we're out.
Peace.
Being on the GT 2020 is the closest thing to Marty McFly's hoverboard that I could possibly imagine.
Oh, I feel like I'm gliding across the ground.